Hi, here I wanted to briefly talk about symbolism in the Tokyo Olympic Games of 2020, which were held this year. I actually haven't watched any of it because I don't have a TV license, but in general, the TV audience went down by 30% compared to 2016. We can see immediately that these events have lost their meaning and that this is felt worldwide. And that's because these are collective human events. And there's nothing human about them anymore. Here I wanted to talk about dark satanic symbolism. So the satanic is always inferior to the light, to the goodness, because it can't create anything. It just leads to misery, destruction. It uses fear, lies, temptation, just like materialism and fame. The dark forces can only operate if they show the truth, but they can disguise it. They cannot force us, it is ultimately our own free will how we react to these temptations and these conditions. Looking at the Olympics and before the US presidential election, or more precisely, Biden's inauguration, we see satanic symbolism everywhere, with lots of parallels to the dystopian movie The Hunger Games. Okay, let's have a look. So we can notice already a couple of things which are different to the previous years. Well, first of all, there's no audience, which is a key ingredient in sports competitions and performance arts, and instead this is replaced by a dystopian black and white barcode looking structure. This guy looks more like a dark priest, and here we see the athlete, a black woman wearing a white muscle, reminding us of dark times in human history. A key thing, of course, is that she has to put on the medal herself. Let's look again. So she's shaking the head, which is a very negative behavior. It's this moment of triumph. Still shaking. It could be that he asked her a question and she said no. Maybe he asked her if she can breathe, and she indicated that it is difficult at this moment. But nevertheless, it's incongruent with the moment of triumph of winning. What is this here? It almost looks like a muscle, like the one she's wearing. So she indicates that she can't breathe with her hand symbol. It's an emblem that she needs fresh air, and she's closing her eyes. That's a sign of tiredness and stress. She's still shaking her head. And we see it's 36 degrees, so it's super warm, probably very humid, and they wear a muscle. So a quick word about the medals. So we have the gold, silver, and bronze medals for the winner, runner-up, and second runner-up, and they are based on Greek mythology. They symbolize the golden age when man lived among the gods, the silver age when youth lasted for 100 years, and the Bronze Age, the era of heroes. Besides being valuable, precious metals, the gold symbolizes also the sun and the silver the moon. The winner's medal, the gold medal, features the face of Zeus, the Greek god of the sky and king of all gods, Nike, the winged goddess of victory, and on the backside, the Acropolis. Decorating someone with a medal is honoring someone for his extreme hard work and endurance and for competing. Here at the Olympics in Tokyo, these medals are not physically awarded. The athletes have to put them on themselves. So these athletes are not honored. These symbols of the gods and of goodness are not passed on to these athletes. There is a disconnect. This guy is not touching the medals. The athletes are muscled up, a symbol for dogs and slavery, and they were used at Guantanamo Bay to break and condition prisoners. Okay, let's look at it one more time. It's very short.
AIDS gibt's nicht mehr, Grippe gibt's nicht mehr. Krebs in jeder Beziehung gibt's auch nicht mehr, es gibt nur noch Corona. Aber ca. 130 Millionen Hungertote soll es geben durch die...
Okay, the commentary is also very interesting, but we know about the facts. Of course, we see more symbolism, while sport is a social collective event. We see the disconnect between the athletes. Of course, this is disguised as social distancing, but this is extreme social distancing. So normally, these athletes on their steps, on the podest, would be apart anyway by, I don't know, 1.5 meters maybe. Now they separated them symbolically even more to 2.5 or 3 meters, which is completely unnecessary. We see the podest is made out of these black cubic looking objects. I mean, these are not exactly cubes, but they remind us of black cubes. And this is another satanic symbol. Of course, we also see a lot the color red, but that's because of the Japanese flag, red and white. And we see also the temporal confusion. So we see the year 2020 when it's actually 2021. Symbolizes confusion and madness.
Maßnahmen weltweit. So ist es. Keine gute Bilanz. Und eigentlich schade, dass man Maske tragen muss in diesem Falle bei dem Abstand.
And she's waving and bowing to an audience made out of black and white boxes. This must be a very low moment in her career as an athlete.
In der frischen Luft eigentlich Quatsch, wissen wir inzwischen, aber hat sich noch nicht rumgesprochen. 15 Meter 1!
There's nothing human about this event anymore, and very few people are interested in it. It has no meaning anymore. As a satanic can't create anything, it can only destroy, enslave, etc., it ultimately can never win, but it can do lots of collateral damage on the way to its own destruction. Let's hope this ends very soon. I just want to end with some more positive pictures. How we normally think of family and social events like sporting events. We think of people smiling, being close together, embracing each other. These pictures provide confidence for a brighter future. So thank you very much for listening, and I'm curious how you think about the Olympic Games. Have you watched any of it? And what goes through your mind when you see these pictures? So please leave your comments, and I'm looking forward to reading them, and talk to you soon. Bye.